It started with a late-night Amazon order, a discounted smartwatch for $99, heart rate monitor, sleep tracker, step counter, full Bluetooth sync. For Jay, an IT manager at a mid-sized software firm, it was just another gadget. Until the login started, unknown devices, unfamiliar IPs, access requests at 2:47 a.m. And what came next nearly cost him his job. Welcome back to Decoding Cybersecurity, where we unpack the real-world stories behind digital threats. I'm your host, Rakesh Nayam, and today we dive into a tale that proves it's not always the hackers you expect, sometimes it's the gadget you wear. Chapter 1, The Purchase, The Cheap Win. Jay had always been security conscious. He used app-based 2FA, kept his devices updated, used a password manager religiously, but his fitness band had broken. So he ordered a replacement, one with great reviews, quick delivery, and a low price. It connected seamlessly to his phone, synced his notifications, even unlocked his device with wrist detection. It felt smart, it felt secure, until day 4. Chapter 2, The Setup When the Watch Wasn't Smart. That morning, he got a security alert, a login from Kolkata. He lived in Pune, he reset his password, assumed it was a glitch. But the next day, another alert, then another. His office security team reached out. Multiple suspicious logins linked to your account. We need to escalate this. Jay was stunned. He ran malware scans, factory reset his phone, updated every app, but nothing worked. And the pressure at work was mounting. Chapter 3, The Discovery, The Bluetooth Backdoor. So he went to a private cybersecurity consultant. They scanned everything, apps, connections, ports, logs, and there it was, the smartwatch silently sending Bluetooth packets even when idle. The consultant dug deeper. Turns out the watch's firmware had a vulnerability, one that allowed background packet sniffing, silent payload drops, remote server pings to an unverified domain. It wasn't just reading my steps, Jay said. It was reading my credentials. Chapter 4, The Case Study, From Headlines to Warnings. And Jay's case wasn't an isolated one. In 2022, a UK government contractor reported random reboots and suspicious logins after pairing a cheap fitness tracker. Security researchers found the smartwatch firmware pinging a remote server in China every 12 hours, exfiltrating contact lists, Wi-Fi data, and device IDs. It was later revealed the device was running an unpatched open source firmware with built-in tracking modules. The result, a full-blown incident response protocol, all from a gadget that cost less than $3,000. So if you think Jay's story sounds far-fetched, think again. Chapter 5, The Betrayal, It Was Someone He Knew. Now here's where the story turns personal and chilling. Trying to trace the smartwatch's origin, Jay followed the seller's GST number and address. And what he found? A registered local distributor in Bangalore. Perfectly legal. Nothing shady on the surface. But the name behind the distributor? Rayan, a former colleague from his previous company. Someone who had left the firm after an argument over, ironically, security policies. Rayan had been quiet, tech-savvy, and deeply embedded in the systems Jay once maintained. Now here he was behind the company distributing these vulnerable smartwatches. Coincidence? Maybe, but too close to ignore. Rayan knew what apps Jay used, what platforms he logged into, what tools were allowed at the office. If this was revenge, it was executed like a pro. Jay couldn't prove it, but he had enough suspicion to forward everything. Logs, IP traces, permissions to the cybercrime cell. Because this wasn't just a breach. It could have been a targeted digital hit. Trivia break. All right, time for some cyber trivia. Let's see how plugged in you are. According to SonicWall's 2024 cyber threat report, by how much did IoT malware grow globally in 2023 compared to the previous year? Was it A, 27%, B, 61%, C, 103%, or D, 147%? Stick around, I'll drop the answer right after the next segment. Chapter 6, The Playbook, The Anatomy of the Attack. Here's how Jay was compromised. 1. Bluetooth pairing was insecure, no encryption, no PIN. 2. The companion app asked for permissions far beyond what it needed. 3. It transmitted data to an overseas server in timed intervals. 4. And once access was granted, it pulled clipboard data, contact sync, even token information for session hijacking. In short, Jay handed over the keys, one permission at a time. Chapter 7, The Prevention. Don't let a gadget open the gates. Here's how to protect yourself like a cyber pro. 1. Avoid unknown brands for IoT devices. If the brand isn't known or doesn't have security documentation, don't wear it. 2. Check permissions aggressively. Bluetooth shouldn't need your contacts or your camera. Period. 3. Never link sensitive apps to unverified devices. Don't pair your phone with banking apps, authenticator tools, or email on devices you don't trust. 4. Disable auto pairing and Bluetooth discovery. Turn off Bluetooth when not in use. Use it consciously, not casually. 5. Use a separate Wi-Fi network for smart devices. Segment IoT from your primary network. It's simple and highly effective. Trivia answer. According to SonicWall's 2024 Cyber Threat Report, by how much did IoT malware grow globally in 2023 compared to the previous year? Was it A, 27% B, 61% C, 103% or D, 147%? And the answer is D, 147%. That's right. IoT malware attacks nearly doubled in half in 2023 alone, crossing 110 million attempts. It's not just PCs or mobile devices anymore. Your smart plugs, watches, cameras, and even your fridge are under siege. Chapter 8, The Send-Off, From Risk to Wake-Up. Cybersecurity isn't just about strong passwords and antivirus software. It's about what you connect and what you trust. A smartwatch may count your steps, but it can also count on you not questioning what it's doing in the background. So the next time you buy that deal of the day gadget, pause, inspect, protect, because what's on your wrist could be reading more than your heartbeat. It could be reading your future. And now, you know what to look for. Chapter 9, The Mission. We learn, we defend, let's keep decoding. Thanks for tuning in to Decoding Cybersecurity. If you found this story helpful, like, share it with someone who wears a smart device and subscribe to stay one step ahead of the next threat. Until next time, I'm Rakesh Nayam. Stay smart, stay skeptical, stay secure.